Hello, today I'm going to show how to plot a graph, okay, or any plot, whatever you want, when you do any RMS simulations, okay. So the first and the foremost step is you need to select the element on which you want to do the short circuit or load disruptions or whatever it is, okay. It can be switching on or off a load, or you can short circuit a line, so it is your choice, okay. So for example, now I want to switch off this load and turn it on after some seconds, okay. So first, what will I do is I'll go here, click on it, right click on it, define, okay, results for RMS or EMT simulations, okay. Once you give, your component will be added here, and then now close it, okay. And then now what you're going to do is right click on it, you're going to define, okay. So you have already defined this, and you can select the parameters whatever you want. So double click here, and then you can select all of them, which is default, okay, which are default variable state variables or variables, and you can make it go back using the back button. And you have voltages, bus result, signals, calculation element parameter, reference parameter. You have a lot of these things. Now go to RMS simulation, okay. And now, for example, if you want to see the voltage, okay, so click on it, it'll be added, okay. And now I'm going to current and power, so I want to see the active power, so it's added, okay. So you have to go to RMS, okay, and then give okay. So it's selected, all the variables are selected. Now close it, and now you need a plot, so select it. And if you want to give a name, you can give a name for it. And here, okay, you gotta double click on here, and you have to give for all calculations, okay. And you have to select the element. What was the element we selected? It was the load. So select it, and then what variable you need to plot. So double click on here, and if you want to choose active power, press okay, and you can change the color. So now, for example, I'm doing it in blue, and the style. So double click on it, and you can choose whatever style you want, okay. However your graph want to be, you can choose it, okay. For example, I'm choosing this, or let me choose this, and then give okay. And the width, okay, so the normal width is 0.5, or if you want it to be very clear, when you're using some light colors, you really need it to be very clear, right? So at that point you can choose the width to be, you know, a little bit big, and press okay, okay, and then give okay. So your plot is already there, okay. But okay, the basic thing is you need to define, okay, you need to say for this particular load what event has to be done, okay. So here, if there are some previous load events which are calculated, you can delete it off, okay. That you can check it by this simulations of events or false. It can be seen here by clicking this symbol, and by clicking this symbol you can see what are the result variables what we have selected. And you can close this. Now you have to set it, you have to initialize the conditions, okay, from the load flow. So click here, and it is the default ones, okay, the balanced positive sequence. And now you can give okay, execute, okay. Once it is executed, okay, now you click on this one, which is start the simulation, okay. And you can give for how many seconds you want. Here normally it is zero, because since I already have done it for 30 seconds, it's showing that. Okay, now you can even do it for 20 seconds or 50 seconds, it is your choice. Okay, so 20 seconds, and you can choose the display result variables and press execute. And once this is done, okay, so it'll check all the conditions, okay, and when you will be able to see the result. And now you might wonder, where is the result? Okay, now you just have to click on this so that you can see the result there. Okay, you can see it. Okay, and now if you really want to know, like, because one more thing I didn't give here, because your plot goes extremely like this, okay, it because you didn't define what type of fault it is, okay, so this is the common mistake like everybody does. So you need to define what kind of fault you need to do, okay. So again, go back to run the load flow, okay, and then get back to the system, select the load, okay, right click, give define, and you can choose either a switch event or a load event or a transfer event, okay. So switch event, I'm trying to do a switch event, and I want this to switch at 5 seconds, open, the break should open, and okay, and then you will see the simulation, the switch event here, okay. And now I want to close it again, so define switch event and give how many seconds you want it to be. So I am giving 10 seconds and you can give close, okay. Once you give close, what you can do is give okay. So now you can check whether whatever event you added, it is here, okay. So it is the switch event and it is a close event for that, and then give okay. And now you can once again, you can run the load flow just to initialize everything. And now once the load flow is run, you can calculate the initial conditions and give execute, okay. And then if you have entered all the if the load flow is balanced, then only this process will execute, else there will be a pop-up saying that the load flow is not converging. So then you need to check each and every bus whether the line flow is proper, the bus voltage is proper, the transformer ratings and everything is proper. You need to check that, okay. And once now everything is proper, and now what you need to do is start the simulation, and for 20 seconds execute, okay. So now you can, so for example, if you want to see the plot, right, I told you, you can press on this. So even now you can press on this, okay, and you can give any variable. So for example, the first one I thought did was active power, and now just in case we need voltage, you can choose voltage, and here double click on it, all calculations, choose the element, okay, it is load 14, and select the variable. So I want the voltage magnitude, and I give okay, because the earlier color I selected as blue, now okay. So you will see the voltage, and here you will see the active power, okay, and give it like this so that you will see the complete active power and the plot, okay. And if you want to give the, you know, the x-axis and the y-axis, you can right click and you can give the scales, okay, the x-axis scales and the y-axis scales. So that is how you need to do. And for voltage, now you press this one, and this, you will see the voltage, okay. So this is how you need to plot the graph. I hope this helps. Thank you. Any questions, please email me, or please email me. Thank you so much.